Hello friends, welcome to Kbtutorials. In this tutorial we'll see a small sanity check kind of operation, how we can automate that scenario. Let's say there is a new feature that got added in your application as part of this sprint and which they have added in the drop down. Okay, so from the drop down, the entry point is drop down, and from the drop down if you select it, it will go to the other page. Okay, so because of this the count, so they have added, let's say like this. Okay, let's say previously three elements are there, in elements are presented in the dropdown, in dropdown previously. Okay, now they have added a new feature, that means four elements will be presented in dropdown, right? Four will be presented now. Okay, now your scenario, sorry, it's a four elements. Okay, so your scenario is like, how many elements are there? Okay, it's a small sanity check. How many elements are there? So presented in the drop down. That's a small sanity check. That is the first thing, and this we'll see how to do a reusable, how to create a reusable component, component for this as well. Okay, so for this for the similar kind of example, I have taken a Facebook. Let's say Facebook is your ongoing sprint application. I know this is a stable version of application, but in your case is an ongoing sprint version application. Okay, so let's call application under test, application under the test, AUT. Okay, so let's say this is your dropdown. Okay, so previously they have only five elements, now they have added few other elements as well. Okay, so if you just inspect a small sanity check scenario we are checking here, if you just inspect here, they have given ID. Okay, ID as part of ID and name also they have given. Okay, so based on this, how we can write our own XPath. Okay, so here they have given select, but most of the times nowadays in advanced JavaScript like AngularJS, React.js, they are not using select friends. So make sure your script is independent of that. Okay, ID as, I think it's a month. Okay, ID is a month. And how many elements are there in this dropdown? This I came till here. Okay, this is what, this is my thing, and how many elements are there? So just after that is our option. Okay, is your option, and how many elements are there? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 13 are there. Okay, this thing we are going to check. Okay, this thing we are going to implement here. So what I am doing is, I have taken a Chrome driver here and I need to go to that particular web page, isn't it? So that particular web page is my facebook.com. so let me copy paste this. So first I am doing the static way, then I'll try to implement a reusable component on it. Okay, so once it is loaded here, what you can do is, you know that how many elements are there here, right? So for that, what you can do is, you use find elements concept here. Okay, and I am using XPath. So this is my XPath here. So this is my XPath, guys, and if you just click on it, you will get the size. Okay, so int size, just close this, use sysout, size is, let me try to execute this and let me show you the output. Now you can see started loading. I'm using Selenium 4 guys, so in your case it might be a little faster, in my case it might be a little slower. So it started loading here, as you can see. But as you can see here, we found some issue, it seems, because it is little, there is no weight I have given, maybe because of that only. Let's see. Invalid selector exception. Okay, it's not a valid selector, it seems. Not a valid X path it is showing, but in my case I got it properly, isn't it? So let me see one more time by X path. Okay, sorry, it's X path is not copied properly. So let me copy it here and paste it over here. Hey, copy. Paste. Okay. So let me re-execute it. Sorry for that. Execute one more time and let's see. So it started loading the browser and it is going to the particular web page. Okay. And it's still executing, isn't it? Now you can see the size is 13 I got. Okay. So previously for you, what has happened? So in your case, maybe the previous size is 12. Now you got the particular size as 13, right? So this is a small thing, small sanity check you can perform as part of your application. Okay, in automation. So how do I write a reusable component? So I hope till this it's clear. Now how to create a reusable component? So if you see, this is web elements, right? So here what we can do is public static int count of elements in drop down. In this case, let me say let me pass list of web element, that is ls. Let me import my list here and I need to add a return statement. Okay, before do it, what you do is put try catch. I'll tell you why I'm using try catch here. Exception E. Return null in this case. I will just give return 0. Here. As of now, let's give return 1. I'll going to modify that. Okay, just to show that, remove that thing. Okay, so now here what I can do is return ls dot size. Directly I can just send this size. Okay, now let me explain why I kept try catch. Is maybe this element, that X path might not be correct. Okay, so in that case what you will do, in that case I'll going to use this kind of things. Okay, and instead of this web elements, okay, let's try to do it, not a big deal, list of web element, let me create ls is equal to wd got find elements by X path. What is the X path? You know this X path, isn't it? Okay. Then let's use sysout. Let's use size is can directly pass this function. Be careful when you are doing this ls. Okay, that means this list I am passing here and I am getting this size, isn't it? Okay, and I am going to modify this as well, friends. So this is one reusable function that we can create. Let's see how it is going. Now you can see it got loaded, and now you can see we got the size. This is a one reusable function that we can create, one. Okay, I'm going to show one more reusable function similar to it but different parameter. Instead of this web elements, a list here, what I'll do is I'll just pass the locator. Okay, so public static int count of elements by xpath dropdown, something like this will create. Okay, so here let me create a string, let me pass that string here directly, and same friends, try catch. Return 0 in case that is not correct, or else you can put print stack trace as well. Exception E. I'll try to do that. E dot print stack trace here. Yeah, now I'm adding here. Return. As of now, what you can do is, as of now, let's keep it one. Then what you can do is, we already have a driver, right? WD. So this part, you can, what we can do is, we can make it public here. Okay, give me a second, let me adjust this screen. Okay, now what we can do is, instead of this, just copy this and put over here public static web driver WD. Okay, simple. Now directly WD got find elements by xpath. I am just using that xpath here dot size. This entire thing, cut it and paste it over here. So I'm just finding these elements here and using that locator here, getting the size, I'm returning that. Okay, so in this case, let me show you the output directly. So what we can do is just copy this and send it over here. Paste it here, copy it, paste it, and copy this particular method, paste it, and pass your locator. So my locator will be like this, isn't it? So this directly. So now let me execute one more time. This is another reusable component I have created. Okay, just passing string as a locator, using the xpath, I'll find it here and I'll return the size. So let me execute one more time. So these two I'm using So let's see how the output will come. So it's all about creating that reusable components, friends, because when you find this kind of drop down scenario again, you don't need to write much code. Okay, now you can see it's got loaded properly. Now you can see we got the two outputs, one directly by passing web elements as a parameter to a function, and another is by passing a locator where I'm using the X part to find out. Okay, so this is a small sanity check we can do, and let me know if you have any doubts in the comment section. I know we can directly calculate the count as I shown in the first process like this, but it's not recommended when you are using as part of your framework. For learning process it's fine, but when you're using a framework, it's all about creating these reusable functions and utilizing many times as possible. So I hope it's useful for you guys. Do subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thank you.